Hi friends, today video is about how to get out of stress or anxiety or depression, or you can say that how to quickly come out of the depressive thoughts or anxieties. The fastest or the best method is to identify the root issue which is troubling your mind, root cause which is troubling your mind, and act on that root problem or solve that root problem. That is the best way to come out of it. However, it happens sometimes when people go into depression or in a state of anxiousness, it is not the one issue. Sometimes it happens that there are a number of issues and they all come together at the same time. So, and even if you're not able to identify the main issue, there are certain basically steps which you can take to get out of the state of an anxiety or depression. So let's go one by one. Number one. Start replacing the thoughts which are making you depressed or anxious with the positive thoughts. Now, this is not only a logical or theory I'm saying. I would like you to practice it right now. Many times we do not appreciate basically what we have. So let's say, close your eyes for the next 30 seconds. Or next 20 seconds and think about it, three really good things which happen in your life. I would like to say again, I would like to repeat again, please do it now. If you're feeling anxiety, if you're feeling depressed, right now, close your eyes, think about it, three best things which has happened in your life. Even one thing, if you can't think of three things, even think about one thing which you really feel good about, which you feel that you are privileged. I'm sure most of you will feel better when you start focusing on those thoughts or those situations basically which we feel that they are blessing. And I'm sure everybody has at least one. So whenever basically next time you feel surrounded by those thoughts which are making you depressed, focus your mind on something good which has happened in your life. That is step number one. Step number two, research says outside, you know, outdoor activities or physical activities or physical exercises, they release those hormones which release the stress. So I would say minimum, the simplest exercises, 30 minutes morning, 30 minutes evening, simple walk. The best is try to visit a park where there are lots of trees and greenery. It makes things much better, but at least even if the park is not there, 30 minutes minimum morning evening walk, and I'm definitely sure you feel much better about it after that. Number three, try some yogic breathing exercise, simple deep breathing exercise, or alternate nostril breathing exercise, or simple gentle yoga, or simple meditation exercise. Any meditation type which you think which suits you, give it a try. If you're confused basically about a meditation technique, you can basically search on the YouTube my name and 10 minutes guided meditation Subodh Gupta. You can try that. You will definitely feel good. Because all those activities, this yoga, meditation, they actually take your mind away from those thoughts which are making you depressed. And when you actually stay in the present moment, when you're practicing yoga, when you're practicing meditation, when you're focusing on breath, you are actually in the present moment. And when you're in the present moment, you will feel, when you learn this art of staying in present moment, there will be less and less stress, or you will be affected less by the outside stressful environment. Number four, omega-3 fatty acids. I think I was reading somewhere that Harvard University did a research and they find a correlation between omega-3 fatty acids and the depression. They said the higher the quantity of omega-3 fatty acid, the lesser the symptom of depression. So I will say that try optimum quantity of this, but take it from the natural food, say from the nuts, instead of taking it from the fish or something else. Social interactions, very important. When you are feeling lonely, when you're feeling anxious, when you're feeling depressed, please never stay alone. Never stay alone at home. Move outside. Go and talk to people. Go and talk to friends. Always surround yourself with the people who are positive. And nowadays, even though there are a lot of drawbacks of social media, there are some positive aspects as well. So, for example, on Facebook or on Reddit or some other places, there are many social groups where you can interact with people who are going through similar situations. So either you join physically, some place which is where you can interact with the people who are going through similar situation, or only on the Facebook itself you can interact with people and you can explain your issues, what you're going through. And generally it is seen that people, when they are going through similar situation, they try to help each other. So you will not feel lonely, actually. You will feel supported by your community. So social interaction is very, very important. The most important or the ultimate way or the final way to get out of this problems forever is to find purpose in your life. Or find your passion. You see, most people, I'm using the word most because that's how it is. Let's say most people resent their job or they don't like their job. The reason is because they are doing it just because of sake of making money. Now, I'm not saying that not making money is not important. It's definitely important to take care of your basic expenses. But then if you're not focusing your time, even 1 hour a day or 2 hours a day, something which you love doing. So I think you're focusing your mind on an area basically which does not fulfill you. So it's extremely important to find your passion in your life. And if you can basically make your passion as your work, then imagine you never have to work again in your life. So it's very important to find passion, find purpose in your life and start focusing on that, start working in that direction. And you will feel that energy is coming to you. You know, you'll feel more energetic. You'll feel more lively. So I think that these are the points which will definitely help you to get out of the stressful situation. Before ending, I went to one meditation camp and I was very stressed at the time. And one more thing you have to remember, that nobody on this planet is stress-free. Everybody has stress in this life. Every human being has a stress in the life. If you are a human being, if you're alive, stress will be there for every single person, to you, to me, or to almost every person. Only thing is that nature of stress will be different. But stress issue will be there almost in every person's life. Unless you become Buddha stage, then obviously less. Obviously none. Or if you are on the path of that, becoming a Buddha, then yes, obviously your stress level will be, stress issues will be less, or stress will be less. But otherwise, for a normal human being, stress will always be there. So yeah, I was saying that I went for a meditation camp and the teacher basically said very, very, very nice line. And he said that it's easy to be pleasant when the life goes like a sweet song. So it's easy to be pleasant when life goes like a sweet song. But a man worthwhile is a man with a smile when everything goes dead wrong. So I really like that statement. Because sometimes in life, there will be a situation, you know, when you will be put in a corner. No matter how good you are. And yeah, it's easy to be smile, you know, when life is just going exactly your way. But if you can basically smile in that difficult situation and accept the reality as it is, and then actually work on that issues or the problems basically which are causing that depressive thoughts, I think that is a way out. I hope you enjoy this video. And don't forget to like, share, subscribe. And remember to press the bell icon so you receive the notification for the next video. And if you have any queries, please feel free to put down in the comment section. I will be happy to reply it. Thank you very much and have a very lovely day. Bye-bye.